better plan to convince the people. Okay. Sree Iyer. Now, everything that the Narendra Modi government has not been flawless. There have been bumps along the road, some nasty, nasty shocks along the road. You can't fix India in 5 years. You ain't going to fix it in the next 5 years also. And creating 5-10 crore jobs is a humongous challenge, no matter who's in power. The answer is, who's got the better model? Why do you think Narendra Modi has got a better model and is worth sticking for that model for another 5 years as a risk versus giving up somebody else's alternative?
For example, the demonetization. However the implementation may have been, the importance of the demonetization cannot be underestimated. There was a lot of fake currency that was entering the Indian system. It was it was getting very difficult for Indian banks to cash that, number one. Number two, he has shown will to go and strike inside Pakistan. I'm not talking about numbers or anything like that. This is the first time that India called.
Yeah, but we'll talk about Pakistan in a bit. Let's talk about the jobs, okay, and we'll talk about Pakistan certainly in a bit. Let's talk about the jobs. Yes. If Narendra Modi and the BJP are saying that, look, we are building so many kilometers of roads a day, that's got to be creating ancillary jobs. If you're building a tunnel, if you're building a highway, if you're building a ferry project, we are creating jobs. If we are giving so many loans per year, we are creating jobs. If we are opening so many bank accounts, we are creating jobs. If that is the logic, then the only risk the people of the country take is that we have a plan. Here's the plan we know. From the Congress, we are awaiting a plan. Here's a plan we don't know. It could be better, it could be worse. Why shouldn't the people of the country take that risk and take a leap of faith with the Congress or any other alternative?
I see a vision on part of Modi. For example, by doing all this infrastructure, he has laid the foundation. He's also given GST, however flawed the implementation might have been. The fact is that GST is here today. Okay. More people are paying taxes, and the processing is getting better. It may have been flawed, but it is getting back on shape. So he is building these fundamental blocks on top of which you are going to see a lot of vertical applications. I'll give you a simple data. India is, I think, the number two or number three in terms of the new startup companies generated. And these are all people who are either putting their own savings or they're requesting their family and friends to put their money in. So I see a lot of those things
you're right on some counts, but also when it comes to AI and machine learning and cloud data, we are nowhere. We are bottom rung. So hopelessly behind that it makes you wonder. Robotics, we are hopelessly behind. So these are certain things. Yes. You can compare it to China if you want to compare it to. So those are also realities. And I'm not blaming Narendra Modi or Rahul Gandhi for those things. I think it's worth thinking about. The party yet. Sree Iyer, why does Narendra Modi need another 5 years if so much has already been achieved? Why not give somebody else a go?
You know, he has crossed the bridge, in my opinion. I'll give you a simple example to rebut Mr. Krishnakumar's observation about Air India. You know, Air India figured out a very innovative way to fly the world. From United States to India, now they have non-stop flights. And these non-stop flights fly in such a way that they always have the tailwind, which means you can reach India from United States in 15 hours. This is the first airline that figured this out.
But
you have
all
to give
know
them
that,
some
sir.
Time.
The truth is, under the
what's
NDA
your point?
Government,
Sree,
Air
what's
India
your point?
Debt increased to 55,000 crores.
My point is that Air India has always been a rather leaky elephant.
You people have siphoned up money of Air India.
No, we have to give time for Air India.
Okay, let's not go on to what happened with Praful Patel at that time. Okay, let's not come on. We'll get completely sidetracked. Sree, what was your point? Sree, what was your point? My question was, why more 5 years? I've not understood your point, sir.
Yes, my point was that there was some innovation in the thought process that went into making these flights non-stop. Okay, so these things take time because you have to gain the confidence.
Okay, fair enough. So why does the BJP now need another 5 years? Just to fix Air India? Certainly not.
There are lots of things that he has initiated that will bear fruit only in the next term or probably even the term afterwards. For instance, I'll tell you, the paid TM adoption by the street hawkers is a huge hit. You don't have to worry about, oh, I don't have change, so I'll give you a chocolate. That part is gone. Now you can scan you or whatever the amount is.
Okay, how does that okay. Small things. No, he's saying these small things add up. These small things add up.
It makes things easier. He's not making any sense.
He is.
Until I honestly am trying to figure out that if this is not about personalities, as all the politicians
on the panel today have told me that it's not about personalities, they've repeated it. Some have been more honest that this is about issues. Then I'm trying to figure out what the issues are. Okay, so
Rishabh, if you will let me finish.
Yeah, Mr. Iyer, finish quickly, sir. Please come get to the point, please. I'm short of time. Yeah.
All he has done is make things move more efficiently. Okay. He is greasing the squeaky wheels. And it takes some time before the planes and trains start moving on those wheels. We have to give him some time.
I agree things sometimes take time. And I agree that India is a big and complicated and difficult to manage country. Certainly, whether we have a clear plan, we have at least some plan for Mission 2022, which was delineated, in fact, a year and a half ago. This is Sree Iyer. India is still a poor country. We still have people going to bed hungry at night. We haven't solved our problems. We haven't solved our security. Everything is not done. So what are the challenges that you see ahead for the next 5 years which need to be addressed regardless of who comes to power? In the end, we're all one country.
You know, one thing we did that almost went unnoticed was the deal to get crude supply from Iran as well as from UAE in Indian rupees. This takes the pressure off of the foreign exchange. Okay, and the dividend of that you will see only in the years to come. Because remember that the direct cost to indirect cost, whenever you have a 1 rupee raise in the price of petrol, results in 4 rupees in commodities that depend on transportation.
Yeah, so again, my question was different here. My question was, what are the few challenges that you see before us that regardless of who comes to power or who's better dealt to handle them, will have to handle? What are the few challenges that you see?
The first one is India is about to enter into a debt trap. India's finances are in a very, very sensitive state.
Okay.
I don't want to talk too much about this because it's a little complicated topic. Maybe we can have a special hangout on this. You may want to bring some more economists. There is a problem there that is looming crisis, and this is thanks to the UPA NPA mela that they started. I'm sorry if the NPA number is
What's number two?
Has considerably increased under the NDA government. Yeah, but much higher than
what
it was
under the more people declare NPAs as actually healthy for the economy. But okay. Is that the only problem? Is there everything else sorted with the country? We only have one problem.
It was recalibration. Review of the whole process.
They have made that point. Exactly same point.
First the figures.
Only one problem.
Please stop this man.
No. You need to create a conducive environment for jobs to happen.
Why do you want the Modi government
has an idea. They may have to change the finance minister, but that's okay. There are going to be some changes when 2019 comes because you need somebody with much more of a macroeconomic perception.
You're taking a macroeconomic picture. Jobs and debt, certainly everybody will agree with you. Those are reasonable concerns.
There is no security.
If national security is a political issue, can it be a politicized issue? I'm asking a subtle question, and I think Mr. Iyer will understand the nuance. If it's a political issue, can it be a politicized issue?
Why?
Okay, ma'am, we heard you. Let me say your take.
We are Indians. Why do you want to differentiate between religions?
Ma'am, religion, we're not talking about religion. Ma'am, we're talking about national security.
Why should you differentiate about the religions?
Okay, Mr. Iyer. Mr. Iyer, a political issue, but can it be a politicized issue? That's my question. Mr. Iyer, there is a chance. Yeah, take
okay. It. Yes, Rishabh. National security is the responsibility of any government that comes to power. But what we have to see is how different governments handle the crises when they erupted. After 26/11, what did the UPA government do? Zilch. Nothing. At least Modi tried to hit back. I mean, you got to give him credit for that.
So, yes, it is that Modi has done better.